you know, as a bow hunter, your season never really ends. You're constantly out scouting, checking trail cameras, moving stands, things of that nature. But what made this season so special was my kids decided to come this year. That added a whole new level of fun to checking the trail cameras, to moving the stands. You know, I got to teach my kids a lot of things, and I can see they're starting to spark an interest in the sport, and that got me really excited. We spent a lot of good quality time out in the woods this year. Well, after months and months of checking cameras, moving stands, scouting in the evenings, the season finally gets underway. And just as my luck would have it, the bucks decided to change their pattern, and the first couple weeks of the season were tough. Well, I wasn't seeing much in some of my timber stands. You know, I had those set up to try and catch them coming from the bedding areas out into the feeding areas. So one night I decided that I was just gonna go set up a stand on the edge of a cornfield and just watch and kind of see if I could figure out where the deer were coming from. It actually paid off. You know, I saw a really good buck in the field that night. The following evening, I came back down to set again, and I was actually kind of thinking of moving the stand farther down into the cornfield, up the way where that big one had been feeding in the field the night before. But, you know, I thought better of it. I decided that I'd go ahead and sit in that area one last evening and see what happens. You know, I figured you never know. Maybe tonight would be the night that he would work his way down. But I never would have imagined what was about to happen. Caught a glimpse of something moving behind me. Couldn't really tell what it was for sure, but I got the camera swung around, and pretty soon he got a little bit closer, and I could see it was a younger buck that I had gotten quite a few trail camera pictures of this deer. I don't know what it is about that deer, but I wanted that buck, and he was working his way towards me. At this point, I've been watching this buck out in the corn for a good solid half hour. He kept playing tricks on me. He'd act like he was going to walk away, but then he'd turn around and come back. But after, you know, another 5 minutes or so, I could tell that he was finally committed. He was going to end up walking past me.
That shot hit him way forward. I think I hit the shoulder. I don't know. was hanging out, but I saw some pretty good blood when he was standing over here before he crossed the creek. Looked like there was some pretty good blood pumping out, but know what happened. I'm gonna have to watch the footage and find out.
You know, when he took off running and I could see that much of my arrow hanging out, my heart just sank. You know, I couldn't figure out what I had done wrong. I knew where he was standing. I knew he was 25 yards away. And to have something like that happen, it's a sinking feeling that is just horrible, you know. But I decided the best thing to do was just pack up and back out. You know, he ran back to the east, so when I loaded up, I went to the west. Well, it was definitely a sleepless night. I got home last night and watched the footage, put it on the big screen, and the wife was nice enough to let me use it. It looks like I got a little more penetration than what I thought. He definitely ducked big time. I mean, he dropped quite a bit when I shot and nicked the back of that shoulder blade. But from what I can tell, it looks like I got about 8 inches or so penetration. So I'm hoping that was enough to put him down. But I made some phone calls and I got my cousin, Mr. Dustin Mason, to come with me this morning. We're just gonna walk back in here and just go real slow. I'm hoping that he bedded down, you know, and he expired overnight. It's been roughly 14 hours or so now since I shot him, so he's had plenty of time. I don't know. It's gonna be nerve-wracking. Let's go find out. From my stand, about 30 yards from where he entered into the timber here out of the fields. It's looking pretty good. He was definitely spraying and we got bubbles in it, so I'm feeling a little bit better. I'm gonna feel a lot better if we can find him. Let's go. It's been 1,200 yards or better now.
Yeah.
Dry up. I mean, can't even find the arrow in
a good day. We've scoured every square inch of this farm. And there's nothing. We never found the arrow. We had, I don't know, 1,000, 1,200 yards worth of blood trail. The last 500-600 yards was just little tiny drops, about 10 yards apart. Then we lost the blood trail for, I don't know, 200 yards, and I just happened to stumble across it again. It was only about 20 yards long, like he bled 3 different drops. And that was it. Never found my arrow, nothing. I don't know. I'll come back out and look again another day, but I think it's pretty safe to say I'm not gonna find this one.
So a couple weeks had passed since I lost that buck. You know, I'd been out hunting several more times, really hadn't seen anything, but I happened to have this Friday off of work, so I decided that I'd go ahead and run into town, take care of a few things that I needed to take care of, and slip on out to the stand. Figured I could be there by 10 or so, and I was just going to sit for the rest of the day.
All right. It's November 9th. It's Friday. I got the day off work today. I had to go take care of some stuff this morning. And I'm planning on sitting most of the day. We got a southeast wind. So my favorite stand over on the field edge is just completely out of the question. Been seeing a lot of action over there. So I'm kind of upset about that, really. But I know most of the deer that I've been seeing coming out of there have actually came off of this ridge and the next ridge over. they love to bed on these two hillsides. So I snuck in here to this set of stands, got climbed up and got the camera set up. I never really took into account that I'd be filming myself. I'm looking around here and man, there's still a lot of green left in here. It's still really thick, so I'm hoping I can get everything on film. I hope it looks good. I don't know, we'll have to see. He came out of nowhere. Oh. He came out of nowhere. I had two does. work in that hillside behind me forever. I don't even know if the camera's in focus. Oh. Oh. I was watching them. This little half rack came in. I gotta calm myself down. Okay, so this little half rack came in. I had him at like 15 yards at one time. I was actually studying him real hard because I got two bucks in here that I got a bunch of pictures of. I thought they were half racks, but they've just got a little nub that comes down off the side. My daughters absolutely love those deer. So if that was one of them, I was gonna shoot him just for my girls. But after studying it, I could see it wasn't. He was actually busted off. So I was kind of going back and forth, filming him down here to my right and the does up here to my left. And I heard something kind of crashing around, and I look up and I saw something else coming down. I thought it was the other doe because I lost sight of one of them, but it turned out to be the biggest buck that I have shot with my bow. I think that was a good hit, but I don't even know if I got it on camera. I was crammed up against the tree. The camera was off to my side. I could barely see the screen. I know I got him in the camera when he was standing there looking. I mean, he just about had me pegged. Oh, but I think he only got a step or two before I shot, so it should be on film. I tried to grab the camera to get him running away, but I don't know if I did or not. Oh, man. God, I have been sitting here all day, all freaking day, and I had not seen a thing. A busted off little 8-pointer a half hour after I got in the stand. I was seriously thinking the hunting gods did not like me anymore. Oh. Oh man, all right. I've gotta watch the footage. I gotta see where that hit. I just watched the footage. I must have bumped the camera or something right as I was releasing. Yeah, the camera swung to the right a little bit. I didn't get the shot on film. Oh, man. I thought for sure. Well, I'm gonna make some phone calls here. It looked like it hit just behind the shoulder. It should be a double lung. I think I heard him fall down. Man, I wished I would have got that. Oh, man. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry. It's just too much to try and do yourself. I just climbed down, look for my arrow. I can't find it anywhere. My knock didn't come on. And without having the footage to know exactly where that hit, even though I think it was right behind the shoulder, I think I'm just gonna back out. Oh, I hate sleepless nights. I think I got maybe 2 hours of sleep all night long. It's about 5:15 in the morning or so. Wagner's on his way. He should be here about 6:30, so we're gonna go down and look for him.
Just beating myself up.
It's all right. It's all right, we'll find him today.
Hope so.
I'll have to watch the footage and take a look at him.
Yeah. What little footage there is.
Well, we got back out here this morning. We're fixing to cross the field here and start walking up the hill. And with any luck, we're gonna find him about 400 yards that way.
That's what I'm hoping for. Don't do it to me again, bud. I can't stand this. Tell me you're seeing him. I can't believe that. I can't believe that. Oh man. After all the emotions this season, I mean, it has just been up and down, just nonstop. We've been out here seriously 5 minutes. 5 minutes. And we found him. Well, I didn't find him. My good luck charm found him. Oh man. I gotta see him. Well, we got him. Oh, this is just unreal. Man, he did. He crashed within, had to be 10 seconds of when I shot him. That was him crashing that I heard. But, you know, without having the video to go back and look at and not being 100% sure where my shot was, you know, I already lost one deer this year. I wasn't going to try and do it again. You know, I did everything right with the first one. Fortunately, he's still out running around. I actually did see him the other day. But I wasn't going to take the chance of kicking this guy up. I just thought, you know, just back out. Just back out. There's no reason not to. It's not going to hurt him to sit all night, other than my emotions, which were running wild for the last 13 hours. But it is all worth it. All of it. All the heartache. Then you finally come in and get success like this. This is just awesome. Just awesome. Well, now comes the fun part. Time to tag and drag.